Landlord, the Duke of Northumberland, building flats on the plot. Emma North has been to Isleworth to meet two of those who say it's much more than about veg.
I've got sweet corn, which haven't popped their heads up yet. And there's a marrow, I think, over there.
This is Grace Gray, and she's cared for this patch of soil in Isleworth for three decades.
The very first thing I put in was raspberries, because there's very much my favourite fruit.
Her landlord is the Duke of Northumberland, with a fortune of more than £300 million and the owner of Sion House. The next time you see this programme, Bridgerton, it'll be set here. His estate wants to build flats on the allotment, which has been here for a century.
It's just unbelievable that somebody who is so much themselves can deprive so many people of what would be a lovely opportunity. So many families who've been locked down in flats for months and months and months on end. And what would they give for a portion of allotment? They'd give their right arms for it. It's just so lovely.
One of those people is Carmella. She used the allotment as a place to breathe as she recovered from COVID. She joined a recent protest against the Duke's plans.
People before profit!
To make their point about how they felt, they dressed as peasants.
We want him to be on our side, like in any nice, beautiful fairy tales where there are heroes and villains. We want him to be a hero like us, because we have been happy to be here. We have been happy to recover and finally come back and be in nature again.
Northumberland Estates told us that they are delighted to be submitting an exciting new application, revised to take into account the wish to retain part of the site for the allotments. They say it includes affordable housing and 30 homes for staff at West Middlesex Hospital. And they say it would be a shame if they were to miss out because of unsubstantiated objections of a very vocal minority. The Duke's described you as part of a vocal minority. What would you say to that?
I'm really annoyed that the Duke is painting this as a vocal minority. I know it's not a vocal minority because I speak to everyone in my ward. We've had 500 letters of opposition to these proposals versus only two letters of support. It's an entire community united against a bad plan.
There are fears that if the Duke's application fails, the allotments will be closed anyway and will run to weed. People will have a better idea of what's likely to happen within a month. This place may well be a source of great peace, but one thing is certain, its tenants won't go quietly. Emma North, BBC London.